You're watching Ramping Up Your English. This is segment 2 of episode 66. With a surfboard, land-dwelling humans can get an experience with nature in the ocean, an experience that's not available on land. Now, those first steps into the turbulent world may be a little awkward at first, but skill level improves, and that happens with experience and with learning. So when we look at what's been learned about whales, we can be in for some whale-sized surprises. Scientists who study the anatomy of whales and compare the fossils of whale ancestors have come to a shocking conclusion. The ancestors of whales once lived on land. That's right. Somewhere in the far distant past, large land animals took to living in the ocean and became today's species of whales. And there seems to be no end to the things that you can learn about whales. Let's see what some English learners in elementary school recall from their study of whales. English language learners share what they're learning about whales in this video.
How does the mom feed the calf?
He drank milk. From the bottom.
They have to come up to the surface once in a while so they can catch a little breeze.
Whales have to go up on the water to get some air because they're mammals.
Some whales don't have teeth. They have that hair, but I forgot what it's called.
Baleen.
Baleen.
Now, what do the baleen whales eat?
Plankton and krill.
Yeah.
That's right.
I know something about killer whales.
What? Tell
killer
me what.
Killer whales eat seals and other things.
Fish.
Like
fish
and that stuff.
Where's his mom?
The whales go up to the surface to breathe. They can't breathe underwater. They have to go up somehow.
Baby whales are born different from almost all other mammals.
This is the gray whale. It swims on its side and it shakes its fin.
Here's his baby that drinks milk a lot.
That drinks milk and stuff.
As soon as it reaches the surface, the baby starts to breathe. Later, it starts to take milk from its mother, or like all mammals do. The milk is very rich.
What does it do in Mexico?
Has his babies. Like, wait. Yeah, this is his baby right there. It's his newborn.
Chicken pox.
Adair, what do you know about whales?
Some whales, the great whales, they go to Mexico.
Great. Who else knows something about whales? Okay, go ahead.
Some whales stick together.
Great. What do you know, Daniel?
The blue whale is the biggest whale in Earth.
And hold it up so we can see it. There you go. Good job. Who else? Okay, Jahira.
Some whales hunt together.
Great. Anyone else want to say something about whales?
The gray whales swim to Alaska.
Okay, what did you learn yesterday?
The more blubber they have, the colder water they can go in.
Tell me what you know about humpback whales.
Well, humpback whales have two blowholes, one for breathing in old air and one for breathing in new air.
That blue whales can hold their breath up to two hours underwater and go really deep.
Sperm whales go really deep, like so, to escape predators. And that a blue whale, when he gets his air through his blowhole, he goes all the way down deep to get his food.
Tell me about baleen.
Baleen, when they catch krill and the other plankton, when they catch krill and plankton, they catch water in their mouth too, and then when they let out the water out of their mouth, the shrimp and plankton get stuck to their baleen,
He can go really deep that the pressure is too hard. And for some whales, they can't go that deep.
The humpback whale sometimes travels thousands of miles just to find the best plankton or krill.
When the whales, they have babies, they come out and then they take the whales all the way to the top of the shore so that they could breathe some air for a couple of minutes, and then they go all the way back down to the ocean.
Whales are mammals, even though they look like fish, and they give live birth, and they give milk.
The blue whales?
I know it.
What do you know about blue whales?
Blue whales are the biggest whale. They are the biggest mammal in the world.
That every food chain has to start with a producer, and one big producer in the sea is plankton.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
I got 11. Here's the bottom.
Whoa.
That can be right.
Put small
there.
Fish right here.
Me, I got it. Then, that's what I say, I got it.
Got a crab, an orca, a clam.
I got small fish, aqua
orca right here. For what?
Middle fish.
I don't think the sharks eat
it. I got medium sized fish.
Hey, pelican, what's
pelican?
They eat small fish.
It's a small fish.
What are they?
Horses.
What?
No, wait. Get in the same spots that you were in yesterday.
No.
Dude, just let go. Just get in the same spot you were yesterday.
Okay.
I was right here.
No, you weren't.
I said what?
No, he was right here.
I was right here.
I remember that was scared right there, falling right there and cracking.
Ready, set, lean back. Okay, Abraham, let go.
I should explain that the last part was a demonstration of an ocean food web and the results of having part of that web disturbed. No children were hurt in the making of that video.